Hello friends, welcome to this video on circles. Today, we will discuss about angles subtended by a chord at a point. Friends, on a circle whose center O, if you take two different points A and B and join them, then the line segment AB thus formed is called a chord of the circle, where AB is its minor arc and this is the major arc. What do you understand by an angle subtended by a chord? Let's try to understand this concept. If we draw a line segment AB and take a point C, which is not on this line segment AB, and if we join both ends of this line segment with point C, then angle ACB will be called an angle subtended by line segment AB at point C. What will we call all these angles made by chord AB in this circle? You can think of the answer by pausing the video. Yes, friends, all these angles are angles subtended by chord AB. Angle ACB and angle ADB are angles subtended by chord AB at points C and D located at major arc AB and minor arc AB respectively. And angle AOB is the angle subtended by chord AB at center O. Is there a relation between the length of the chord and the angle subtended by it at the center? Friends, if we increase the length of chord AB here, then will there be any change in the measurement of the angle subtended by it at the center? Let us find out. Let us take different chords. As we move closer to the center, the lengths of the chords will increase. As we can see, if the chord is longer, then the angle subtended by it at the center will also be bigger. Friends, let's discuss a question. If a circle has two or more equal chords, then will the angle subtended by them at the center also be equal? Let's find out. Draw a circle whose center is O and the radius is 4 cm. Now make three chords PQ, MN and GE which measure 5 cm. And join these points with the center O in this way. Now, with the help of a protractor, find the measurement of the angles POQ, MON and GOE subtended by the three chords at the center. You can see that all three angles are equal. Friends, you can repeat this activity by drawing more circles. You will find that equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center. This is a theorem. Let's prove it mathematically. According to the statement, draw a circle with center O whose two chords AB and DE are equal as given. We have to prove that angles AOB and DOE subtended at the center by these two chords are equal. Join these points like this. If we prove these two triangles to be congruent, then these two angles will also be equal because the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Friends, look at triangles AOB and DOE. This is an isosceles triangle because their sides are the radii of this circle which are equal, and we are given that AB and DE are also equal. Therefore, both these triangles are congruent according to the SSS congruence rule. Hence, angle AOB will be equal to angle DOE. Friends, will the converse of this theorem also be true? Think about it. We will discuss it in detail in the next video. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed an angle subtended by a chord at a point. See you in the next video, where we will study the converse of this theorem. Thank you.